Sumpthing, which cost a tenner until decorations were added on, and now it's over 60 quid.
From Leicester, Sumpthing.
This cost under a tenner to build, they claim. It's a demented pickaxe with heavy-duty steel plate armoured areas powered by four car starter motors. They believe they're into something good.
Hi, I'm Dig. This is my mates Jeff and Johnny. This is our robot for Sumpthing. This sharp, pointy, axe-y type thing is directly goes through the drive system, so every time we change direction, the axe comes over a bit like that. And also on the return, this time it incorporates a forklift truck type of thing, which is down here, which hopefully will possibly pick up and flip the opposition. These spikes are also good for impaling, because we can get up to about 15, possibly 20 mile an hour, but we're not sure, but we can't outrun it.
Robot ears, stand by.
And they've taught Pitbull well. Ivor's hero's Bart Simpson. He looks like him too. And Sumpthing, with Dig and his hair.
3, 2, 1, activate.
Sumpthing by far the faster of the machines, and immediately on the attack with a huge pickaxe slamming down there, powered by four 800-watt starter motors. But back comes Pitbull on the attack. Plenty of bite in the clamp. Sounds like a traffic warden. And in goes Sumpthing onto the flames of torture there. And I think he's immobilised right from its first charge. And Sumpthing here is out, I'm sure, on fire, burning, and a hairy end to Dig in his team. Burning up in flames the hopes of the Sumpthing team. And Pitbull stands triumphant, and all he has to do now is avoid the house robots who come in for the kill. Steering away, coming back on Sumpthing again, Pitbull. There's Killalot there with the horrible lance. Pitbull about to close those jaws on Sumpthing once and for all. That's Sergeant Bash, top of your picture, coming in. Oh dear, oh dear, oh dear. Pitbull's trying to attack Bash, who grips Sumpthing, tearing and rending machinery, splitting sumps, ravishing wheels, and in comes Killalot, twisting and turning that horrible lance. I think Dig needs to go back to his tunnels from whence he's come with Jonathan Lort and Jeff Germany. He actually wants to go to live in a disused railway carriage in Australia, Dig. Take Sumpthing with you, because it's not a lot of use for anything else. It's food for thought for Killalot. It's a mere bauble. Look at those horrible eyes, evil. Pit, 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 pit. You're going down, Sumpthing. You're going down. And you've gone. Oh. All that work and planning. Sumpthing out. Pitbull the winners, quite clearly, right from the start.
Sumpthing. It's a bit of a grungy bot. What was your thinking behind the design of this?
Right, we wanted to build something that was dead low tech, so we can hack back at the computer electro age of the scientific generation.
Yes,
indeed,
fighting
so.
Talk!
Dirty fighting
talk. And it's
talk.
Built for brawling.
Rob Lester, Sumpthing.
This war's veteran returns with a wedge shape to bulldoze, a pickaxe to shred, a spike to puncture. Took 2 years to build with parts plucked from rubbish kits. Is this something special or something and nothing? Because it was last time around, and the word activate came flying out against the Pitbull, and well, that was it. Over in a trice. Killalot finished them off. Something and nothing, surely, last time around. Can't do worse, can it?
Hi, I'm Dig. This is my mates Johnny and Jeff, and this is our robot, the Sumpthing. Greatly improved from last year, hopefully be more reliable. We've still got the great big axe, and we've still got the spikes and the forklift type thing. Got a bit of a wedge at the back here as well.
A bit more weld this year.
A bit more weld, a bit less weight.
Roboteers, stand by.
Little Fly with Andy Hoskin at the controls on the right-hand side there. Little Richard in the middle. Here's Sumpthing with Dig in the middle at the controls. There's Weld-Dor, Phelim at the controls with half of Belfast City in there with him too. Interesting to see Sumpthing here. They say it's got a little bit of welding, a little bit of this, a little bit of that, and a little bit of a razor blade, I would suggest, in Dig's household. Not a complete one. That's Weld-Dor on the right now, and Little Fly coming rushing in with the 1,000 RPM agricultural lawnmower blade spinning. I thought it was stuck for one moment. Sumpthing's lasted longer than it did last time around with the pickaxe blade coming in. Fast on Little Fly, bouncing away. Good aggression by Sumpthing. Weld-Dor looking to cause some damage. Sumpthing spins away. The shunting in top of your picture. Bash to the left. He wants to stay clear of those. Oh, slam! Like Dodgems in a fairground. Good even contest this. Again, that blade seems to be stuck by Little Fly. Once it hits metal, it seems to jar, jag, and then have a redundant spell. That's Sumpthing with the great axe coming down once again. The pickaxe built for brawling, Jules describes Sumpthing. Low tech in the war against high-tech computers. Sumpthing fighting back for the age-old traditions, perhaps. Slam goes the axe on Weld-Dor's frame. It'll need Sumpthing to penetrate that 6mm polycarbonate shell, though. But all the aggression from Sumpthing, and Richard Digg, to give him his full name, at the controls there in the middle, is doing splendidly here. That's a little nudge from Weld-Dor on Little Fly, and again it was Sumpthing that came slamming in. Little Fly's rotational blade spinning, but not causing any major damage. Trying to get things going, Andy Hoskin at the controls. Young Richard there from St. Margaret's School in Kent giving him advice. Sumpthing to the left-hand side, very even. This could go to the judges. Style control, damage and aggression. They'll be looking there to add up the points. Little Fly, a little bit too slow for me. 4 miles an hour top speeds. That dig at the controls again of Sumpthing. The aggressor certainly in the heat. On the wedge-shaped front of Weld-Dor, trying to get an angled run in so that the axe can cause maximum damage. Weld-Dor back strengthened. A new robot for this competition, knocked out in round two by King Buxton last time around. Weld-Dor, has it stopped, I wonder? Sumpthing is certainly still active, but that was the penetrating blow of the axe of Sumpthing. And I just wonder, Weld-Dor, I think, has been immobilized by that blow. Weld-Dor has been immobilized. In comes Shunt now. Weld-Dor's out of it. So the judges will not have to decide. Weld-Dor has gone. Shunt with a smack of the axe. Bash in there behind as well. Very good even contest. It was one decisive blow, but the Sumpthing axe that caused all the problems, and that's the end of the road for Weld-Dor, Phelim Lundy, Damien and David in his team. Disappointment for them. Kilowatts there with the blinking eyes of menace and destruction. The torch also a bash. There's Shunt as well. But they've survived. Little Fly just the pit descends, and the destination of Weld-Dor into the gloom of the pit.
Came all the way from Belfast. They've got to turn around and go back again. They go out.
Well, we've dug ourselves in, haven't we, at the back of the arena, the Sumpthing Scrapyard Chic team. How you doing?
I think the laugh says it all, really. We're overjoyed we made it through the first round.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Have you made any repairs for this round?
Yeah, we've got a different axe on it because we wanted a bit bent, so we found a chisel and welded that to it. And oh, the wheel's got a little bit shredded by the fly, so we've had to...
So what's your message for Mousetrap? Have you got one?
I don't know, really. They're not the worst people in the world, you know. They're not full of diodes and computer chips and stuff.
No, quite
got some pneumatics going on, yeah, so, you know, we'll have to see.
Chains and cogs there. There's some chains and cogs in there, we noticed, but I feel
think
fairly confident.
Might be their weak pot, though.
Oh, so it's not all good stuff being low tech then?
No, not all the time, no.
Yeah, you want to beat them anyway, don't you?
Oh, yeah.
Roboteers, stand by.
Well, the big cheese for Mousetrap is Jason at the controls. Sumpthing Scrapyard Chic. What's next? Gorgeous grunge? Classic crusty?
Three, two, one. Activate.
What's next for Sumpthing? I thought they were very impressive in the first battle. Nippy around the arena, very aggressive. Good control. They need to stay away from the Mousetrap weapon. Goodness me! Did you see the force, the velocity of that Mousetrap weapon springing into action there? Didn't catch Sumpthing, but the warning signs are flashing. Oh, there it goes! And it has pinned Sumpthing's weaponry down! A great slam of the Mousetrap! Well, there was a prod of the axe, and look at that for a slam of the Mousetrap. I wonder why they didn't keep it there, though. They pinned Sumpthing in. They could have dragged it towards the pit, dragged it into a CPZ, let the house robots take over. Did they let Sumpthing get away too cheaply there? Will they rue that decision? Sumpthing bouncing off the front of Mousetrap, using the wedge shape to get in underneath Sumpthing, a ground clearance of 8 millimeters on the Sump. Little bit tentative now, Sumpthing again, the Mousetrap weaponry comes down. See the great spring on top there? The chassis of Mousetrap used to be an office desk, by the way. As Sumpthing's prongs come flicking out the front, and the axe again, the big axe. But all of a sudden, that doesn't look too punishing, does it? This is very even at the moment, but Mousetrap is suddenly moving. And it's Sumpthing doing all the aggression. And Shunt senses something is on. No, Mousetrap's okay. Just moving away. The first gear perhaps stops once more. Is everything okay with the Mousetrap controls for Jason Launchbury? Jason responsible for the electrics of the team. His dad Stan for the mechanics. But Mousetrap's second best here, quite clearly. Another attack by Sumpthing, slamming against the rear wall. What happened there? Sumpthing has caused its self-distress and damage. We'll have to have a look at it again, but it came hurtling towards the arena wall, and I think Sumpthing is immobilized here. Let's look at it again. Down went the forks on the front, and they buckled underneath, and that means there's no traction for the great wheels. Sumpthing, dig, you have dug yourself into oblivion here. And in come the house robots. Mousetrap was barely alive, but Sumpthing killed itself off. This is dead metal. Oh, what a shame. Oh, that's a grisly end, because they were well on top. But it's the house robots now who will finish off the load. Tech battler Sumpthing, built for brawling scrapyard chic. But I'm afraid in the end, pitted against superior opposition of the house robots after causing itself so much damage, it will be sweet nothing for Sumpthing. Tossed and tattered, bashed and bruised and beaten. In comes dead metal, and Sumpthing is pitted. Cease. What a shame.
Well, Sumpthing mobilised themselves. Mousetrap are still moving, albeit slightly. Mousetrap go through. You've got to be upset.
They're not guilty.
Well, I mean, if he was only moving ever so slightly, if he, well, just, if he just kept away from them and just, you know, just sort of behaved yourselves.
We've got a few good blows in there.
Yeah, I mean, it's lovely, lovely. I actually designed that robot as well. What went wrong?
We've got a chain and it snapped. When the chain snaps, it leaps over and beaches itself on its own forklift. Now, it's a bit of a design flaw, you might think.
A definite design flaw. He beached Sumpthing.
Indeed so, sir.
Hey, you're going to sort that floor out for next time.
We'll try our best.
It's been nice having you here, lads. Let's hear it for Sumpthing!
From Leicester, Sumpthing.
They say this is an ecologically sound robot powered by four recycled 800-watt car starter motors. It has a multi-purpose hydraulic system, a crusher axe lifter, and top speeds of 20 miles an hour. The fastest in the heat.
Roboteers, stand by.
The Widow's Revenge team, Jilly Blood, Emily Cathcart, and Fiona Mason, and their Dig and Jeff Germania of Sumpthing. Sir Kilolots in the arena, Eco Warrior. Are you sure? He doesn't mind what he crushes and recycles. Shunt with a diamond edge axe and scoop. Hardly has a conscience either.
3, 2, 1.
Widow's Revenge have also advertised their machine as extremely attractive, slim, and would like to meet a similar robot for Cozy Nights In. Well, Sumpthing has no plans for a Cozy Night In, I can tell you. With the
circular blades at the front driving up. That blade system is also a crusher, a lifter, and the rolling pin there you see on Widow's Revenge is actually a kinetic spinning weapon. And part scoop as well, something on the attack, slamming down. 98 kilos of machinery there. It is the lighter, only slightly. It certainly is the quicker. Gilly Blood, Vinny's missus at the controls of Widow's Revenge with Emily Cathcart and Fiona Mason, and doing a good job too. At the moment, broadside on to something. They invited an attack which didn't come from something. Now I wonder if Dig and Jeff Germaney have missed a trick there, but they've pressed the pit release, and Widows, you need to get out of the way now very quickly. Has something gone wrong with something? I think it has. And if the Widows sense here, they can come in for the kill as the clock ticks down to a judge's decision. Six. Will the Mascara run in the Widows Revenge team if they get the decision against them?
Both robots labouring towards the end there. We're going to have to go to our esteemed judges. They'll be looking at style, control, damage and aggression.
Well, something the more aggressive early on, but no damage caused or sustained by either machine. The Widow's Revenge driving quite neatly around the arena. In underneath, again, it was tentative. A spark or two, that was the main damage caused in the whole fight. Will that count against something?
The winner, the judges have decided unanimously, and it's Widow's Revenge!
Sumpthing.
Ah, he's back with his team. Dig, call me Mr. Dig!
What's going on here, then?
Well, we're charging our batteries.
Yeah.
For those limited amount of electrical bits we've got in there.
Yeah.
We started in Wars 3. And when we entered Wars 3, we were low-tech then. We are positively archaic now. If you look around you, they're just like, they're so technological.
What he's saying is they're going out in the first round.
Low-tech, a brainless brawler on the limits of control, an archaic reminder of the industrial age. Their description, not mine.
Roboteers, stand by.
Let's have a look at the teams. Axe-C-Dent 2, there's Mel Easton. Hydra with Dennis and Andrew Ledbetter. There's Sumpthing, Mr. Diggs' team on the left, and Dominator 2 on the right-hand side. And in the arena for the house robots, Growler, heavy, very quick. And there alongside him, Shunt with the bulldozer blade and the axe at the back there.
3, 2, 1. Debate.
Dominator 2, the number 6 seeds, and certainly favourites here, and on the attack straight away. But there, Hydra flicking Axe-C-Dent up into the air. It has no Sremec, remember. And I think Axe-C-Dent has been immobilised right from the start. And poor old Mel Easton probably thinks so too, because he can't write. He'll need a nudge from someone very quickly. Sumpthing right in the middle of your picture is very unpredictable. There we're seeing young Andrew Ledbetter, 13-year-old, loves his fishing at the controls of Hydra. Oh, there's the back of Mr. Dig. Don't call them eco-warriors, they say. We'll just call them scruffy warriors. There in the middle once again is Sumpthing, their machine. And as we thought, Axe-C-Dent is about to be counted out. But it looked good. The axe was strong, but no Sremec. No, you can't come into the arena without one of those. And we say goodbye from Competition for Axe-C-Dent, and we're about to say goodbye to Sumpthing if it gets into trouble in there with the house robots. Poor old Mel says cheerio to Competition. Sumpthing still in the CPZ. In comes Shunt with the axe right into the middle there of the Sumpthing team from Leicestershire, dragging it about. Has an internal combustion engine on board there. We're seeing Dominator 2 thrust aside as well by Hydra. Good driving by young Andrew. Pushing and shoving with a 99 kilos weight Hydra. Growler awaits. Destruction on Axe-C-Dent 2. Axe-C-Dent already counted out. And again, two robots go through to tonight's second round. So in other words, it's two from the remaining three mobilized robots. I've been impressed with Hydra. Something's still in there fighting. Dominator hasn't dominated as we thought that team would. Being number six seed. Hydra in and flicking Accident up and over. Something's little pickaxe still going. Now Dominator finally gets its mighty hydraulic axe working as Growler looks on. But Dominator's attack was on a beaten robot in Accident. And Sumpthing and Hydra beginning to team up on Dominator too. And the judges would have taken note. Should this go to a judge's decision, they will mark on style, control, damage and aggression. There on the floor flipper. Oh, that's a great height from the floor flipper. Accident in pieces. Great height this. It's lifting 100 kilos, don't forget. Bits and pieces strewn all over the arena floor. And we love it. And Sumpthing is not fully mobile. And now that's a shame for Mr. D, Jeff Germany, and Paul Bacon, the self-styled king of shame, because Sumpthing's about to be counted out. Quite a war going on between Hydra and Dominator 2, meanwhile. Sumpthing's been counted out. The pit release button has been activated. It's too late for it to turn around. It wasn't fully mobile, you could see that. It was just going around in a circle. So we know then that Hydra and Dominator 2 will be going through. Ooh, Growler comes out for a nibble. Sumpthing is dragged away. Got hold of one of those spherical wheels. And Sumpthing goes down into the pit. Once again, beaten in the heats in Robot Wars. Also there, Accident 2 finally cease. Oh, Mr. D, do your hair. Oh, Mel, well, perhaps not. Well done to the others. They're through.
Sure got you right in. Right in, you know, the gubbins, if you don't mind me saying so.
Oh, wow.
Are you speechless?
Well, I am fairly.
Now take a look at the damage. Where's the main damage?
There is no damage.
What do you mean there is no damage?
Once again...
I've got my damage cam.
No, we've got away unscathed, but unfortunately, the low-techness of the whole machine has kind of let us down a tad. We took the fight to the techno people. We did our best.
Yeah.
But I think we're going to have to retire the old machine.
It's time to go home and start again.
It's putting back in the skip where we found it.